Name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, one God, amen. So before we get into the sermon, let's just, we'll continue with the explanation of the liturgy. And again, if you missed any of these, please refer to this icon in our on our website, and you'll have like all the explanations of every part. So just quick recap on what we started already. We started with the preparation. So before the liturgy, we need to prepare ourselves. And that's why the church offers and invites us to Vespers and Matins in the morning to prepare our hearts and to prepare the church as well. Then there's the, kind of like a transition between the next part, the liturgy of the word, which is the offering. This is where the we pray the prayer of thanksgiving, and we offer, there's an offering, and we choose the best bread to become the Lamb of God, which we are talking about right now. The Liturgy of the Word is what we're finishing right now and has all the words of the epistles of St. Paul, the general epistles, the Acts, and then the Gospel, and then the and it's meditated upon in the sermon, which we'll do in a moment. The Liturgy of the Faithful starts with the three great litanies of peace, the pray for our fathers and the assemblies, and then we said we have the prayer of reconciliation because we cannot pray unless we have peace, right? We cannot pray if we're angry. So we need to be at peace with one another, with God, and within myself. The anaphora, where we lift up our hearts, and then we say the whole story of salvation with the holy, 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 reminding us every week of what happened in that. Next part is the institution narrative. So we talked about how we start with sensing. The priest will sense his hands to prepare himself as he's going to hold the bread to become the body of the Lord. And every time you're answering, we believe, because this is our main belief. Our belief is that this is truly the body of our Lord. Last week, we mentioned how now we're at the point where the priest took, removed the star, which we showed last week, removed the star, removed that little veil, and then basically disposes of it. And then he holds basically the bread with his left hand and his right hand with the four fingers above the holes. At this point, we didn't mention this, or I forgot, I know it's written down, but I forgot to mention, this is when the deacons will basically hold the candles until every time really when we hold the body and deal with it, we light the candles. Functionally, if you can imagine, right, there was no electricity in the days. So this was a key part. So they needed candles to see. So it's not, you know, obviously there's spiritual reasons behind it, but functionally that's why we, you know, I didn't need to see anything. I'm just holding, I'm praying and whatever. But now I'm holding the body, I'm doing something with the blood, so we light the candles. Then we have the part where we actually bless as he blessed, right? So we basically, the priest will look up towards heaven, as it says, he looked up towards heaven to God, who are his father and master of everyone. And when he had given thanks, he'll basically bless the bread. And then basically point to the one of the holes. So we send this very early in the offering. You know, you can't see it from here, but there's five holes showing the wounds of Christ. So basically he'll, and the way you always hold it is the three wounds on the one side and the two wounds on the other side. So that makes basically this the head of Christ and this the feet. So this is, every time we refer to something, we don't refer to it as bread. We refer to the head, the body, the center, and even like we don't say crumbs, we say the jewels or the gems, because they're not crumbs, they're still the body of the Lord. So we had given thanks, that's directly from Scripture in Luke 22:19. We do it for the second time, and he blessed it, right? So we make the sign of the cross, and he holds, the priest will point to the third of the holes, and then he sanctified it. Of course, that's not in Scripture, but that's what we're doing. We're telling you what we're doing. We're sanctifying this. This is just bread right now. But in a few minutes, in 15 minutes, the one that's on the altar is going to be the body. So it's sanctified, it's consecrated to be the body of the Lord. And every time that we mention one of these things, everybody should be responding, amen. Because again, it shows our belief in all that.